Hey YouTube, it's Andrew here. Today I just wanted to show you how I went about fitting a new Nest Gen 3 thermostat to the ducted heating system in our house in Australia. Originally we had one of these old thermostats when we first moved into the house. It's a mercury bulb type. Then probably about 15 years ago now I upgraded that to a Honeywell programmable thermostat. If your system has one of these newer Brivis networker type controllers, what I'm going to show you won't work as these communicate digitally to the ducted heating unit. At the time of this video, we still can't get the Nest thermostats in Australia, so I ended up ordering one off eBay. When I opened it, I guess I was really surprised about the quality of the unit. It was way better than what I thought it would be. The weight of it, the build quality, everything was just first class. So first impressions, very positive. You get the usual stuff like instruction booklets and information on other products, which is fine. In the back of the box there you get a Nest screwdriver, which is a really interesting looking thing. Again, very nicely made, but what really impressed me here was the back plate there where the wiring connects. It's pretty cool. In the back of the box you get a larger mounting plate, which I guess that's used if you need to cover a bigger hole from your old thermostat, but in my case I'm not going to need that, and to be honest I think it spoils the look of the thermostat anyway. To remove the old thermostat, just pull it out from the bottom and lift up and it just unclips. First thing to do is just check what wiring you've got there. In my case, I just have one pair connected to R and W. There is a link in the middle there, which you don't need to worry about when you go to the new thermostat. Take out the two mounting screws and take the unit off the wall. Now, as we saw earlier, my thermostat had a single pair of wires. They were connected to R and W terminals at both the thermostat and up at the heater end. When I went onto the Nest website and used their compatibility checker, I entered in the two wires that I had, the R and the W, and the system came back and said that that would be suitable for running my thermostat. But the research I did showed that that was not always successful. I read that it was better to have a common wire there so that you could provide a good solid 24 volt AC power supply to the thermostat, so I had to run some more wires up to the heater. I decided to run a 6-core cable from the thermostat location up to the heater because I had some of that cable at home, and that would give me the common connection. As well as that, I could do a connection for the fan, which the current thermostat didn't have. The next step was to get up into the roof space to find the heating unit. Luckily it's not too hard to get to, it's just near the manhole. Lift off the cover panel and put that aside. Next, we're looking for the green terminal strip, which is underneath the electronic heater controller, so that we can make the connections for our new cable. Here we see the new cable connected into the terminal strip on the heater controller. We're only using 4 conductors out of the 6, so we've got 2 for spares. The old thermostat used to be connected where you see the blue and white cables. That was the old grey cable that you saw earlier in the video. Refit the cover and head back downstairs. I temporarily joined the old cable onto the new cable up on the roof so that we could use the old cable as a draw wire to pull the new one through. There's the 6 conductors, but remember we won't be using the orange or the green. They'll become spares. Now that we've got the cabling in position, it's time to mount the base plate. I used a couple of plastic wall plugs to put into the plasterboard and used the supplied screws. Another nice little touch from Nest was the built-in spirit level in the base plate. It just helps you mount that level so that the finished job looks spot on. Carefully prepare the cabling so that you don't have any loose strands coming out which may short out under the other terminals. Then it's a simple matter of pressing down the required terminal, pushing the wire in, and making sure it's in there securely. I just pushed the spare cables in the back. I guess I should have taped them up first, but they're not doing anything, so it's okay. That's what it looks like when it's finished, and it's ready for the thermostat to be put on top. Carefully align the thermostat and gently click it into place. I downloaded the Nest app for my iPhone, which we'll use in a little while. The thermostat will now step you through the setup procedure, which is really straightforward. I think the only difficulty I had was working out how to select things at first and turn the dial on the outside to get the right letters and so forth, but you'll pick up on that very quickly. I thought it was pretty cool that the system actually shows you what wires you've got connected, and you can also see that on the Nest website. All that's left to do now is to put the key number that appeared on the screen of the thermostat into the app so that you can control your heating from your iPhone. Very simple. So that's it. I thought the whole setup process was very straightforward. Everything worked well, as it should. So all we need now is some cold weather to try out the heater. I hope that's helped you, and I hope you'll be able to have enough knowledge now to try it yourself. Thanks for watching.